So my name is Alicia, and I'm in 10th grade now. I started classes at Ashcan around a year ago, and I started off doing some curriculum works. I did like pencil technique and acrylic painting and like watercolor and portrait drawings and paintings and things like that. And then currently I'm working on my scholastic competition. Well, there are two different ways for me to come up with ideas. One is more from the concept, and I like to keep some like writings in like my daily life. I like to keep a journal and maybe like my sketchbook. I have this one sketchbook where I keep some of my writings and like my thoughts with some doodles. I think that really helps with my conceptual project, and it kind of helps me to organize all my thoughts. I also come up with project ideas with just, for example, a still life. I'll just set up a still life with like objects I like or I think that has a connection with it. So for my sketchbook, sometimes I like to do doodles on there. That takes like less time because I have like other very like intense schedules. I also have this other sketchbook where I keep more of a finished like drawing or like a little artwork, and I think both help. So some of the themes and connections throughout my work, one is I think I tend to make a lot of emotional connections into my works. For example, I like to show like this emotion of being very tired or like stressed, and like some of my own emotional, and I like to try to put it into my artwork to like communicate that through like the colors. I also like to add like weird and funny faces to show different facial expressions. They're normally more exaggerated, but I find it also interesting because they're kind of like funny, and I feel like it really catches people's attention. Yeah, and I like to have organs. I like to like maybe focus on this one ear in my painting. That's one of my painting. And also eyes, some different organs and body parts. I want to express my own feelings during like some of my like harder times. And I started off doing some like more like having like paintings about my like heavy feelings. And I feel like it became more of like, I just started, when I start a project by myself before I go to Ashcan, I just start off by thinking about how I feel and like what my emotions are. And I like to go through my journals as well to see how I feel like in the past. And I like to add that into my painting.
So the NYU Summer Program is this art intensive program at Steinhardt NYU. And yeah, it's quite a competitive program, and you have to apply with 10 to 20 pieces portfolio and some written essays as well. So I decided to make this program's portfolio with Ashcan. So I spent a lot of time from January to March just making my portfolio, and it was quite intense. But I also think I learned a lot from it because I've never taken any like portfolio classes before, and I got into the program at the end. So I was, yeah, I'm really happy about that. So during the summer, I attended this Fossil National competition, and I made this piece where a hand is in the middle and the background is like ice, glaciers, and the fossil, because the competition requires you to draw one kind of fossil and choose a national park to like put their name on it and the fossil's name. So I chose Silurian gastropods for my fossil, and then I drew a piece where like there are a lot of gastropods around, and one gastropod is indented in the hand, and the hand is in the middle of like the piece. And I really like the idea of the fossil like indented into the hand. Yeah. I definitely feel like my work isn't good enough sometimes. I feel like especially after meeting so many like kids my age and maybe just taking classes at Ashcan, but I feel like it's also like a process because I'm still learning, and then I feel like it would be helpful for me to see how other people's working on their styles and their project. And I feel like, although I feel like my project are not that good, or yeah, like I still try to like just keep it up and then trust the process. Currently, I do 2 classes a week at Ashcan. And so to keep like just consistently making different artworks, I like to keep like smaller sketchbooks, and then I like to write a lot. So like I like to write down everything I feel, like how I feel or my thoughts. I feel like that helps a lot because it helps me think about potential like project ideas. So it would be easier when I actually have to come up with an idea for like competitions or portfolio. So I feel like it's more of a thing that like habit that I think about, oh, maybe I could draw this, or like just kind of observe my surrounding and like the environment I'm in, and then see some like connections to my own like thoughts or like concept. I also have this like Instagram account when I try to post my art. Since I have this account and I want to try to like just keep it going, I feel like it's a good, really good way to kind of like pushing myself to do some artwork. I think the first one I want to talk about is this piece called Haunted Maybe, and it's this bathroom still life piece with watercolor and micron pen, because I really like the whole color scheme, and I like how I added like the faces behind this main character. It really like combined my own style into like the still life, and the whole process from like just setting up everything and then putting everything into the bathroom. And this is the bathroom at Ashcan. And also, this watercolor took me a while to like learn how to use it and like apply it onto the artwork. And I feel like it's a lot different than what I usually do, because I usually do more like vibrant colors and instead of like realistic. So when I was learning about how to make it more realistic instead of like vibrant and like saturated, it was like it took me quite a while, and I learned about color theory through this piece. One of my favorite portfolio piece that I sent to NYU. I really like it because the middle person, the middle character, where like the one that's not a realistic person, it's a doodle from my old sketchbook. So it was really fun to develop my own doodle into like an actual artwork, and I feel like it was really fun to think about the reason behind it, like, and come up with a concept. And like, I used modeling paste for the bottom of each like little island, and I thought it was fun to use it. I also took reference pictures of myself. So the first person and the last person are actually myself like kneeling on a chair in the studio. So it was fun. I think one of the most difficult thing about making art is it really takes a lot of time, and I have to like balance out my time and manage my time better in order to have time to make artworks. And it's also hard when you don't have any ideas. I feel like making art is more about like a habit that you have, that like you just keep thinking about everything, making observations about different things in your life. Like, it's hard because it's not only about like the moment when you're actually in the studio making art. You have to have a lot of different other like life experiences in order to make like good art. Yeah. The most enjoyable thing about making art, I just enjoy it a lot because it's a way for me to learn about myself as well, maybe what colors I like or what materials I like. And I think coming up with concepts or thinking about what like the theme of my artworks also helps me to kind of reflect on my thought process and doing like metacognitive like thinkings, which is very like helpful, I feel like, just not just for art, also for like other stuff. And I just love doing it because like I like to, yeah, it's a very relaxed like process for me. Try to think of it as part of your life instead of going to like a class. I would say like just making art consistently also by yourself is important. I feel like it's important to like just always think about it and make it really like a part of your life, that you just think about it like unconsciously has been really helpful for me because it's my first time actually taking classes at a studio. So I think the whole communicating with my instructors and the other students really helped me with just maybe like making art through like part of like socializing. I feel like it really helps me. And it also gives me new ideas and like teaches me how like maybe like trying different materials and like concepts, and also just receiving helps from my instructors. And they also taught me a lot about different techniques and like color theories and different medias and stuff.
Ashcan Art offers pre-college portfolio preparation courses year-round. Learn more about our courses at ashcanart.com and see accepted art portfolio examples on Instagram at ashcan.art. And please subscribe below for more art portfolio tips.